take your fucking sanctimonious bullshit new core morality and shove it up your ass!
What's up, buttholes? I'm John Forsyth. I'm here on the set of Recruiters, season 2, one of the writers and creators of it. I've been with vettv about 4 years now. I've done everything from props, wardrobe. Wardrobe was the worst. It kind of goes like sex slave, recruiting duty, and then probably wardrobe somewhere in there.
Welcome to vettv.
You know, coming into the show, I really didn't know what it was going to be about. I really kind of thought about your stereotypical recruiters.
So, like, you want to hear more about joining the Marines?
You think they're just a bunch of lying assholes and they're doing it for fun. You know, and they dress up in their fancy uniforms, they get free meals and all this stuff. They don't have to be on base. It was after my first interview with a recruiter, that's when I realized, like, this job actually really fucking sucks. And there's a lot of pain that goes into it. And recruiters kill themselves all the time because it just sucks, asshole. It's one of those things. You just set up for failure. They tell me that you don't get through recruiting duty. You don't get through it, you survive it. That's kind of what they say. Just look at all that and try to find ways in the shows for, like, how can we pinpoint those people and their pain points and make a show that'll hopefully just make them happy. And then I started thinking about what kind of character should be thrown into this situation, and that's where Butler started coming about.
Step Sergeant Butler!
I'm hearing about how you have to be like a big salesman, confident, all animated and all this shit. So I was thinking, like, well, that's not me, so I would make a horrible fucking recruiter. So I'm like, cool, let's put like me and then somebody like Butler, like let's make Butler kind of like me, but then also, you know, with the whole theme of mission versus morals, it's like, I know a lot of recruiters fail because they have too many morals, so I'm like, cool, let's make a moral character who's also kind of like on the quiet side and not like, he doesn't run the room, throw him into that environment, and that's gonna cause a bunch of friction and so much you can do with that, you know, so set him up for failure, put him through hell. So that's kind of where it began.
Shove it up your fat little ass.
In season one, a lot of it was about Butler, and it's him being new to the office and new to the recruiting world, and he starts out as a pretty happy guy. He's got a marriage. He has high hopes for the future. You know, he thinks like, oh, recruiting duty. Like, I don't have to be on base. Like, I'm gonna have time to spend with my wife and everything.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah, baby. Oh. Love that car.
Yeah.
And season one was really built to show people that, like, once you get to this duty, it really tears your life apart, and we see him just fucking go downhill. And his marriage falls apart, everything falls apart, the guy just hits rock bottom.
Fuck this job! Fuck everything!
And that's kind of where like the mission versus morals come in, is like he keeps getting these problems built up and eventually he has to make some decisions to try to, you know, maybe not the most moral things, but he's got to do these things to try to like gain the upper ground again. And coming into season two, it's like more of the office battling outside office influences.
Any soldiers, huh? You want pussy?
Season one's Butler battling the office. Season two is more of them as a team. Finally, Butler's in charge. They're all kind of working together. They kind of have their groove going on. And then you've got this Master Sergeant comes in and wants to micromanage everything and change things. And the Master Sergeant has this anxiety about the past scandal.
Don't worry, brother. I won't let you down. Not after all the shit we've been through together.
He just wants to be like, no, this is how we do it, and back in my day, and all that bullshit. They have these strict rules. Now they can't make their mission. They can't get their numbers as easily. They start hating their lives, and it just kind of forces the recruiters to do worse things. You just can never win.
You ladies like getting fucked?
If we're getting paid.
Boy, then do I have the job for you. You get fucked hard, and you make double what you're making now.
Part of the overall theme of recruiting duty. It's like you just can't win because, like, at the end of the day, you can spend so much time, you can take the kid to Red Lobster, you can do whatever you want. At the end of the day, the person can just decide that they just don't want to go. And then if they just don't want to go, then you didn't hit your number. And then if that was your last one, if this kid just fucked you over, now you got to go in on the weekend for extra training.
There goes my quota.
Now you just missed your daughter's soccer practice. Now your wife wants to leave you because you work too much. And then it just spirals downhill, all because some kid just decided he didn't want to do this anymore.
Can this day get any worse?
The big thing that makes our shit different than Hollywood is really trying to make sure we stick to the realism of it. Because a lot of times Hollywood with military stuff, they're willing to just do ridiculous shit. where like veterans will watch it and be like, there's no fucking way that would happen. There's no way. That's what we're trying to avoid at vettv, to where maybe certain aspects aren't as entertaining as Hollywood, but it's like the people who watch it will watch it and hopefully be like, yeah, that's exactly how it went. So you might have some civilian friends who watch it and be like, this show is boring. Whereas like the people who understand it are gonna be like, no, this shit, I experienced this.
You know what might actually help?
Is if you send me a glass of wine. Because I enjoy a nice glass of Fino after getting fucked.
Especially if it's something dark and painful that we can throw comedy on top of. It's just like, you know, getting away from that realism just kind of ruins the whole purpose of what we're doing.
Wellington, you're a boot. I have socks with more time in the Marines than you do.
Marker.
Yeah, I think the dark humor definitely heals, I think, deeper than just your silliness. Because, like, it's getting a cheap chuckle, like, it helps temporarily. Like, it makes you feel good for a few seconds, and then you kind of just forget about it. And then you start remembering, like, your actual pain and depression and shit like that. Whereas with dark humor, if we can portray it right, the thing that I really like to try to do in some of my stuff, and I think some of my writing ends up being a little bit more dramatic than some of the other people's, and I'm sorry, Donnie, but that's just how I am. the whole purpose of that is to, like, I really want to try to set the audience up to where, like, I want them to feel that real emotion at first. And even if it's kind of shitty for a few seconds, like, if we can remind their bodies, you know, and they can feel it, like, in their chest and maybe in their throat if they're getting choked up or something, it's like, feel that for a second, and it reminds people of what the reality of the situation is. And then if you can smack them with humor on top of that, especially if you can do it quickly, then they, in a short amount of time, they go from remembering the negative emotions, and then you slap them with the positive.
The cookie does it for you, it just does.
And hopefully that can, all in that moment, they can just realize that, like, hey, you can still laugh at some of this shit, maybe it's not so bad, and I feel like that hits a little bit deeper.
Oh shit, I told you she was an attention whore.
Some of that kind of drives what we put into the shows. And for me, like, another big one is looking back at depression and stuff. Like, depression's a big driving point for me. I've felt a lot of that in my life. I've had my extreme lows, you know, I've gone through my little suicidal phase where it's just like, you know, that really understanding of what it's like to fucking hate your life. The content that we make is all about making that better for people. I like to look back on that.
Devil Dog, you sure know how to fire up a Marine.
Thanks, Dad. I'm sorry, Master Sergeant.
And then even if you're just currently going through shit, you're just having a shitty day. Or like if I'm having a shitty day, like today, you know, I've got to be on camera talking and shit. But it's like, you know, I draw from that, and it just always reminds me of like, oh, you know, if I'm depressed or I think back to like my worst times, it's like, okay, that's what it feels like. And there are people out there right now that feel that, and people are probably watching this right now who feel it. And maybe they're even thinking about killing themselves tonight, which I don't recommend. Those are the people that we're trying to help with it, and it definitely fits with recruiting.
I know that's fucked up.
I think when you sign up for vettv, like, yeah, you're gonna have the shows and everything, but you're kind of signing up for a community. Even if you sign up and you don't even watch that many shows, because like maybe you were in the, I don't know, the Navy or the Coast Guard or something, and we don't have that many shows for that. You still have that subscription and like still being able to like talk to people and be part of that community. I think that's one of the most important things, you know. And if you can like subscribe and watch our shows, then you can like talk about that stuff with all the other people and things, which is definitely a plus. But otherwise, just getting involved in the community.
How many cookies is that? Jesus Christ.
It's not just for veterans. That's a big thing that I see a lot. I see a lot of civilians comment on our things and try to get involved in our stuff. And a lot of times they ask, like, well, I'm not a veteran, am I allowed to watch this stuff? And it's like, well, yeah, like, please do, you know, if it helps you, definitely watch it, because dark humor and pain and depression and shit, that's not just for veterans. Everybody feels that shit. So if you're a civilian, please subscribe.
I think my butt cheeks are too squeezed.
Or at least get involved in the groups, because, you know, if it helps you, then that's great. The cool thing about our community, too, is anytime I see civilians comment about that, our community embraces them and pretty much says, yeah, come on in. I have yet to see someone in our fan base tell a civilian to fuck off because you don't rate or whatever, you know.
Just kidding, we love you guys.
Especially because a lot of us are veterans who are out now and we're not connected to our service as much. So it's kind of like, hey, we're all in the civilian world together.
I'm not going to suck a dick anymore. How about that?
No, I don't need that.
You, no, trust me, you want it.
If you haven't subscribed, definitely try it out. We have a lot of shows, something for everybody out there to some extent. And if you used to be a subscriber and you stopped for whatever reason, I know we kind of went through that COVID phase where we kind of had to scale back our quality. I feel like some people may have been frustrated with that, but we are coming back around. So we're on season 2 of Recruiters right now.
I'd suck her clit through her asshole just to get another female contract.
We have season 2 of A Grunt's Life coming out. We're going to be filming that soon. We're going to have Devil Doc soon. So all your favorite shows are actually being done. They're being done properly. Now we have bigger budgets, better crews, more talent, everything. They're all going to be way better than all the other shit that you watched. So if you've left your subscription, try bringing it back here soon and get on board and start seeing what we've been doing now, because we have changed over the years. We're only getting better. So
that's a wrap on this location. Thank you. Yay!
The cast and crew of Recruiters Mission First Season 2. Only on vettv. Subscribe to the watch.
Yeah. Yeah. Woo!